It's called I'll Take the High Road and You'll Take the Low Road. And it's a wine musical.
I'll take the high road.
Yes, and you take Merlot road. This is where rock comes from. That's what hamsters can do for you.
Look at what your friends are missing out on tonight.
Rob is he's always been fond of titles that you don't get to start with, and then eventually you're like, oh, no, I see it, yeah. Yeah, that's his forte. That's our dummy. You don't pay for top-notch hamsters for nothing. So he's got that. I'll take the high road, you take my low road.
And what's the style of this particular song?
Oh, this has got a gospel pump to it.
Oh, yeah.
But in a way that I can handle vocally. You know the title. You know the ones. Simple, yet effective. It's uplifting.
To the waltz or the...
Oh, the old gospel waltz. Ah. No, the waltz.
You know the Elvis one, you know? Yeah, something like that.
The vineyard.
Which vineyard is this called?
It's called Shuttlecock Drive. Wines for the stars.
Shuttlecock Drive?
Yes, wines for the stars, not for celebrities. They're competing to get their wine bottles on the mission to Mars. Everyone, all the winemakers are a flutter because, I don't know, one of those guys, Musk or someone, is sending a rocket to Mars and they, of course, want to take some wine with them. And so whoever gets selected, that's going to be their ticket to wine select success.
There's rumour that Tesla has 6 cases.
That's right. And so everyone's working. And at Shuttlecock Drive Vineyards, they've had some poor years with the vines. But they started to try some different things. They started sort of talking to the vines, and they started dancing at the vines. They started a whole lot of different things, and experimental manure. It's hamster manure. And it's amazing. And so the owner of the vineyard, his name is Stefan. He forego his surname to become one of the vines. Because the vines, when he walked past, you could tell they sensed a little bit of resentment that he had a surname, so he got rid of it. And now the vines have accepted him a little more. And so there he is. He's growing. He's hoping that this year's bounty is going to be the best so far. And then he's walking amongst the vines, and he's feeling pretty good. Because across the road is his rival, the...
Snake charmers.
Yeah. They make an amazing array of wines for all occasions. And they're always, they're the ones with all the medals, you know? Snake charmers got gold medal at the Horsham Wine Show. Oh, look, they got 2 silver medals at the Silver Medals Our Best Show. They can't lose. So he's hoping that at least this time, because if he can't get his wine on board this thing, Snake Charmers is going to take over his vineyard.
And his opportunity will be closed. Gone.
Snake Charmers are always knocking on the door, sniffing around. Oh, when's his vineyard going to be ours? Oh, I can't wait. That vineyard's going to be ours. We're not even going to plant vines there. We're just going to put deck chairs and sit in there reading the newspapers just to rub your face in there. So he's hoping, you know, our hero, what's his name? I can't remember.
Stefan.
He's hoping that this is going to rescue the whole vineyard for sure. So he's wandering around, got a good feeling. And he sings this song as he's looking at his best grapes so far. He sings... Oh no, I'm pitching the wrong musical, sorry. No, I'll go with this one, because I've come so far. So we'll go with this one. Now he sings this song, the vines are everywhere. He sings... You've never smelt so ripe.
You've never smelt so ripe. From I'll take the high road, you take my low road.
How can I look at you? never spend.